and you never left me. How you stood by my side. There were so many times when I came so close. Oh man, death, he tried to take me in. But the reason I'm here is not hard for me to see.
Good morning, Fort Foote family and friends, worshipers in America and around the world. I greet you this morning with a Jesus joy, as once again we've been given the divine privilege to share God's word from God's house to your house. Congratulations to our dedicated, devoted, determined deaconess ministry. We thank God for you and the great ministry that you provide. Because of you, many of our blessings have been pressed down, shaken together, and running over. To God be the glory, great things he has done. Please be so kind this morning to meet me in Romans chapter 16. Paul has a word there for our hearts to be encouraged on this blessed Sunday morning. I commend unto you Phoebe, our sister, which is a servant of the church which is in Cenchrea, that you receive her in the Lord as becometh saints, and that ye assist her in whatsoever business she hath need of you. For she has been a succorer of many and of myself. Greet Priscilla and Aquila, my helpers in Christ Jesus, who have for my life laid down their own necks, unto whom not only I give thanks, but also all the churches of the Gentiles. Likewise, greet the church that is in their house. Salute my well-beloved Epaphroditus, who is first fruits of Acacia unto Christ. Greet Mary, who bestowed much labor on us. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy and precious word. Eternal God, our Father, we come to say thank you for your goodness and your mercy. It's because of your grace that has allowed our golden moments to roll on just a little while longer. We pray now, God, that you would send down your power from on high, that your servant might share your word with your people, that their hearts might be lifted and encouraged. It's in the mighty, precious, wonderful name of Jesus that we pray. All of God's family said amen and bless the Lord. On this blessed Sunday morning, I would that you would pray with me as we preach and teach from the subject, A Beautiful Portrait of a Servant. as we come to celebrate the 15th anniversary of our gifted, devoted deaconess, I thought this text would be appropriate to encourage our hearts for this great day and occasion. Paul writes this book of Romans. Many have called it his top theology, or in the Greek, his top Summa Theologica. Written in about AD 56 in the spring, shortly after he wrote the powerful prophetic book of 2 Corinthians, Paul focuses on the theme, the righteousness of Jesus. The key verse for the book of Romans is found in chapter 1, verse 17. For therein is a righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. Can I get a witness? A beautiful portrait of a servant. Paul begins by saying, I commend unto you Phoebe, our sister, which is a servant of the church which is at Cenchrea, that you receive her in the Lord as becometh saints, and that you assist her in whatsoever business she has need of. For she has been a succorer of many and of myself also. Paul says, I commend, means to praise and honor officially and formally. We come this morning to commend, to praise and honor, recognize our deaconess officially and formally. You have been servants of the true and living God. He says, I commend without hesitation, without resistance, without any reluctance. We recommend unto you Phoebe. We've been blessed to have over 15 deaconess who in spiritual sense all are named Phoebe. For the name Phoebe means a radiant, bright light. As men of God, we serve God with all of our heart, all of our soul, and with all of our mind. But we've come to recognize and realize the importance and significance of deaconess. For you know already that there are many situations when we deal with the ministry of women and girls that a woman, a sister in the Lord, has a certain kind of feminine intuition, insight, and illumination that benefits everybody in the body of Christ. So we are glad, we are happy, we have been blessed to be accompanied in ministry by our deaconess. Beautiful portraits of a servant. Unlike today's times when we have King James Version, New King James, New American Standard, Holman Christian Standard, and many other verses, Amplified Version, we have many copies of the Word of God. In biblical times, that was not the case. So by the fact that Phoebe, this radiant, bright light deaconess, was entrusted to take this precious Summa Theologica, Paul's top theology of the book of Romans, to the church at Rome, showed that he had great trust and confidence in Phoebe. It was perhaps the only copy that was available, but he thought it not robbery to entrust it, as valuable as it was, to Phoebe. That's the kind of deaconess that we have at the Foote Baptist Church. We can entrust them with the precious Word of God to be shared among those who are in need and help and assistance. What a powerful expression of commendation without reservations. Phoebe, we applaud you. We slow down for a moment to recognize we can't have the time today to tell all that you do, but we pause and reflect with great joy for the great way that God is using you, my sisters, in the deaconess ministry. Paul gives them at least three commendations. He said, Phoebe, our sister. 1 John chapter 3 says these words, behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, given to us in abundance, that we should be called children of the Most High God. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 25 says, let there be no schisms, fractures, or divisions in the body. We want to honor our sister in the Lord today. She is our sister. We are in the family of God. One of many things that this global pandemic has accentuated for us and emphasize emphatically that we are in the family of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're saved by one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one hope, one calling of us all. We are family, and we gladly recognize our sisters in the Lord. They have great value, add so much to the ministry at Fort Foote and around the world. She's our sister. She's not just a number. She's not just a relative. She's not just a statistic. She is our sister. Can you feel the love and passion that Paul spoke about? My lovely wife, our First Lady Sheila M. Lyles, has taught me many, and one thing leaps off the pages this morning. There is a term in construction called sistering. Can I get a witness? A Joyce sistering is added as an extra identical floor strengthening project when there is a sagging or a weakness or an inadequacy in the physical structure in the floor. You would add a sister joint at least 3 feet to the left and 3 feet to the right. To be more emphatic, you would add a sister joint the whole length of the inadequate sagging situation to strengthen. So when sisters come along beside us in ministry, they add strength and security and succor and comfort to one that is sagging, inadequate, and broken and fractured. Am I right about it? Paul is saying that Phoebe was the kind of sister that would come along beside you, not look down on you because of any inadequacies, but would come along beside you to strengthen you, to encourage you, to lift you, to hold up your head, child of God, give you a word of encouragement. That's what a sister does. All of our deaconess sisters and others are kingdom women and women of the King. There's a sister on the left to uphold. There's a sister on the right to uphold and lift. And together, the area that is lacking has now become strengthened. And once that sister has been strengthened, she goes on to carry on the joy sistering and strengthens another sister whereby she has been sistered. Help me out, sisters. When you really find a true sister in the Lord that is a treasure, a value of great price that only God can give. She is a sister. Can I make it relevant for a moment? When I fell in love with Miss Sheila back in 1976, I was in love, but I didn't have a car. What are you saying? I had an important Saturday date. We were going down near the waterfront in Southwest to Holgate for some salmon, tilapia, and honey sesame seed buns. But problem was, I was without a car. But thanks be to God, I had an older sister by the name of Sarah who had a little 1976 Ford Falcon. I said, sister girl, it's not a Mercedes, it's not a BMW, Lexus, or a Volvo, but I sure need to borrow your car because I've got a hot date and I've got to clean up this 76 Ford Falcon. She said, go ahead and take my car, brother. I'm your sister. I'm talking about a sister that helped me, that'll help you in a time of need. I got that little 76 Ford Falcon cleaned up. We rolled on down 295, went downtown and had a wonderful evening, but it could not have happened without a sister. Is there a situation that you can see, my sister? Is there a situation that you can observe that cannot happen without you being a sister? Sometimes older sisters help to raise us and nurture us as a mother would. Phoebe, our sister, a portrait, a beautiful portrait of a servant. Truth be told, without the sisters at the Fort Foote Baptist Church, not only at Fort Foote Baptist Church, but without sisters in every local church here and around the world, we would not be as strong, as healthy, as the body of Christ needs to be without you. You are essential personnel. You are often first responders, first to show love, first to show faith, first to show benevolence, first to walk in love and kindness. We thank God for you. You are a precious gift from God. We will never, ever take for granted again. Something about a sister like Phoebe. She was a sister in the Lord. This pandemic has caused us not to take one another for granted. Everybody has value. I've seen you walk in love. I've seen you show love. I've seen you demonstrate it at a higher level, all like never before. I'm talking about a portrait, a beautiful portrait of a servant who knows how to sister. You have a certain intuition for nurturing, for ministering, patience, understanding the difference between a cry for attention and a cry for help and a cry for need. God has so gifted you. No one has all the gifts, but there is a special anointing, I believe, that God places on women so that they are able to sister one another. It takes some patience and kindness. Some are Ruth, some are Naomi, some are Esther, but whatever gift God has given you, please continue to use it for the glory of God. Be not weary in well-doing, for in due season ye shall reap and not faint, because God is on your side. Continue in your ministry, my sisters. Even if it's not always recognized publicly, do all that we do, says 1 Corinthians 10:31, whether we eat or drink, do it as unto the glory of God. And God has a celestial recorder. He's observing all that you do for his glory. Philippians chapter 2, verse 3 tells us to let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but when you serve as a deaconess and minister for the glory of God, God sees all that you do. Phoebe, our sister. There have been many situations in the ministry of the Foote Baptist Church family that a sister deaconess has given us insight as to how we should handle it. Truth be told, in this age in which we live, there are many situations that call for in ministry that it's not safe, it's not wise, it's not good for a man of God, minister or deacon, to go alone. We are enhanced and strengthened when we partner with a sister deaconess in this particular situation, so that a better assessment, a better outcome can be given for the glory of God. I'm talking about a beautiful portrait of a servant. My dear sisters, be not discouraged when challenges roll up on your street. Be not discouraged when you have to struggle at times to carry out your ministry because of traditions and all kinds of distractions and delays and discouragement. Press on for the glory of God, knowing for sure that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. God is taking notice of all that you do. He goes on to give a second commendation or high praise and recommendation. Not only was she a sister, she was a servant. God is not sending out invitations for superintendents or supervisors. God is looking for a servant. You may not be Lordy, come Lordy, magna cum laude, PhD, or have obtained certain esoteric academic knowledge, but if you are available to be a servant, God will use you for his glory. I declare he'll do it. Somebody said, won't he do it? She is a servant. From the Greek word diakonos, it means to serve. It's not just enough to be like some folk who have the title but have no interest or desire to carry out the task. Not our deaconess. You are not just carrying a title. You're really willing and able to carry out the task, for you are a servant. You remember back in Joshua chapter 1, 2, Joshua, that great leader that led the people by a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. When it came to the time to share Moses' eulogy, God did not speak of his great leadership, though he was. He said, Moses, my servant. God is looking for a servant. If we will avail ourselves to be used by God, God will use us for his glory. And when God uses us for his glory, here's the many things that will happen. Sinners will get evangelized. Saints will be edified. But above all, God will be magnified. Servant of the Most High God. You cannot have a greater honor. Galatians 5:13 says, Christ himself came not to be served, but to serve as a ransom for many. In fact, a ransom for all of us. He made of himself no reputation, says Philippians chapter 2, but came in the form of a servant, lowly form of a servant, obedient even to the death of the cross. Matthew 10:45 said, if you want to be the greatest among all, you must be the servant of all. God wants to use you in a mighty way. May you continue to yield yourself so that God, as we continue to yield all of ourselves, so that God can use us for his glory. Soon and very soon, the doors of Foote will fly open. We're calling on all servants, step up and carry out your ministry of being a servant. Matthew 20:26 says, the greatest among you, not the one with the highest degree necessarily, not the one even with the most Bible knowledge, not the greatest orator, not the greatest teacher, but the one who must be greatest among you will be servant of all. Can I get a witness? Phoebe, Sister Deaconess, was a sister and a servant. If you want to be first, then you got to be last. Paul said himself, I come not with eloquent words, but the gift of oratorical skills. Paul even said, what they're saying about me is correct. I have no physical amazing presence. I just come preaching Jesus and him crucified. No adding to the word of God, I just come as your servant of all. A portrait of a beautiful servant. She was a sister. She was a servant. Activate your servanthood card. Paul says in the book of Corinthians, one thing that God requires of a servant is that it be found faithful. You may not always be the chair or the leading of the meetings, but faithful one will sign up. Not only will they sign up, they will show up. The word minister and deacon and deaconess all translate from the Greek to diakonos, which means a servant. Paul said, I am your servant leader. Sometimes we get it twisted, think that because we've been given position of leadership that everyone ought to bow and serve us, but the opposite is true. Somebody put it this way. The greatness of a man or woman of God is not determined or based on how many people that serve them, but the greatness is determined by how many people we serve. When it's all said and done, may the work that we do speak for us. When we sung our last song, prayed our last prayer, may they be able to say, here lived, here lies a servant of God. What an honor, what a privilege, what a blessing to be called and used as a servant of the King of Kings, as a servant of the Lord of Lords. Can I get a witness? Beautiful portrait of a servant. A servant does all that the master assigns him or her to do. Thank you again, Deaconess. I've seen you down through the 15 years. I've watched you. I walk with you as you serve in times of need, served in times of despair, served in moments of mourning and bereavement, drying teary eyes, carrying food to the needy, one good deed after another for the glory of God. Up and down 295, up and down 210, all around the DMV and beyond. Can I get a witness? So we commend, we recommend, we publicly, officially praise you, honor you on this day. She was a sister. Take some love. Take some patience to sister another imperfect sister and brother. Oh, that God would give us the spirit of servanthood. Bible said if we humble ourselves, God will raise us up at the appropriate time. A servant is always trying to see the good in somebody, seeing others better than themselves. A servant has this kind of attitude. Jesus first, others second, and me last, if at all. A servant doesn't get to work just from 9 to 5, Monday through Saturday. It's often called the go when you don't feel like going, going when you really humanly don't want to go, but when you start thinking about just how good God has been to you, how he's brought you and me from a mighty long way, you rise up and go and share the love. And as you go, God gives you strength. As you go, God gives you might. As you go, God gives you power, insight, and illumination that you might share the love of Jesus, that it might touch the heart of somebody else to see their burdens get lifted. See them go from judgment to joy, sadness to sorrow. She was a sister and a servant. And now he says, I would that you would receive her in the Lord. Amplify said, in a manner of love and hospitality, as becometh saints, as worthy of a saint. Paul has many friends that he lists here in Romans chapter 16. In fact, I counted about 24 of them. What Paul is saying that a sister and a servant is friendly. The Bible says it this way. If you want to have friends, we must show ourselves friendly. Before we have the divine opportunity to share the word of God, we must be friendly. A friend, real friend, loveth at all times. A real friend does not distinguish between those who deserve to be loved and those who do not qualify, for the love of Jesus has abounded in our hearts, so we can love everybody, sinner and saint, up and down, in and out of all races, ethnics, and nationalities. God, fill our hearts with love so that they will know that we are Christians by our love. We can befriend them. Sometimes in a world of hatred and racism and oppression and all kind of drama, what we need is to be friendly. Some folk are warm, loving, caring, and engaging. Some are cold, calculating, and distant. Some folk don't care how much you know till they know how much you care. Can I get a witness? Be a servant. When a servant goes to the door of God's house, we don't decide who qualifies to enter, because all of us are servants, and we must be reminded and realize that this is God's house, in my Father's house. All are welcome. I'm just a servant. Receive her in the Lord in a manner that's worthy of love and hospitality. We, the body of Fort Foote in particular on this blessed morning, want to be careful and always receive our sisters as they carry out their ministry. We should support them, not stress them. We should encourage them, not discourage them. We should help them and never hinder them. We should push them forward, but never give them push back. Come on, help me preach, teach this morning. Receive her. We receive your ministry, deaconess and women of God. Press on for the mark of the prize of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. Don't let anybody stop you. Don't let anybody block you. Press on in the midst of challenges, in the midst of trials, in the midst of tribulation. You are working for the Lord. Payday's coming. Keep on moving. keep on serving, keep on sharing, keep on loving, keep on ministering, keep on praying, keep on studying, keep on reaching, keep on sistering to strengthen a sister over here, strengthen a sister over there, strengthen a sister wherever there is need. Be not weary. God has your back. As God has strengthened you, carry out your assignment. Assist her in whatsoever business she hath. Any need that she has, we ought to stand ready, willing, and able to help you along this Christian journey. Truth be told for a moment, if the sisters were not at the fort, we would be somewhat anemic, not as powerful as we are on this blessed Sunday morning. Why? She's a sister, she's a servant, but he gives a third powerful commendation. She has been a succorer of many, a protector. Succor means to help, to comfort in need, in distress, and in despair. Can I get a witness? In a hurting world, over 570,000 people have died from this vicious virus called COVID-19. Many in our church, in our neighborhoods, in our communities, on our jobs, and around the world are in need of some succor. They need to know that somebody cares in the midst of my mourning and bereavement and my brokenness and my sense of loss. Does anybody care? God at times may seem so far away. I wonder if God even cares. Can you show some comfort? Can somebody get a sense of what I feel? Can somebody realize I'm hurting, I'm falling down, and I can't get it? My heart's broken. My loved one has been taken away. I just don't know if I can make it. I just want to give up on life. Here comes Phoebe to give succor, to bring a meal, to give a word of encouragement, to pray with them, to hold my hand when the night looks dark, when it looks like there's a light at the end of the tunnel. But the way I see life now, the light at the end of the tunnel is probably an oncoming train. Does anybody care? I'm crying out to God. She has been a succorer, help in a time of trouble, rock in a weary land, walk with a sister, pray with a brother. Be there when they're going through their moments of mourning and bereavement, knowing that God will bring them out to a sunlit path of hope and fulfillment. Tell them that Psalm 30, verse 5 says, weeping may endure for the night. Oh, but joy is going to come in the morning. Baby, I understand what you're going through. My heart has been broken. Also, when I had a loss so a year ago, this is how God ministered to me. I cried till I couldn't cry no more. I prayed till I couldn't pray no more. Oh, after a while, at the midnight hour, God showed up, and I come to realize spiritually that darkest hour of night comes just before daybreak. No, I'm not going to have a nervous breakdown. I'm about to have a spiritual breakthrough, though my heart has been broken. It's more open to the glory of God. I need to know that you care because you cared for me. Walk with me through my dark time. Who now can I help? She's a sister. She's a servant and a succorer. If I could get to the family of Dante Wright, if I could get to Micaiah Bryant up in Columbus, Ohio, if I could go to Elizabeth City down in North Carolina, see the family of Andrew Brown, if I could see the family of George Floyd, many are hurting in the DMV, right in our own family, right in our own church, right in our own backyard. Oh, if you have a heart to care, God will use you for his glory. If you have a heart to love, many children are broken, been the victims of child abuse. Many grown adults have not yet processed and dealt with their own traumas and bereavement and loss and abandonment and neglect. God has given us the precious power and anointing with the Holy Spirit to give succor and comfort in the midst of our own hurt and pain. Can I get a witness? Beautiful portrait of a servant. Paul gave two verses to this woman, Deaconess Phoebe. A radiant bright light. We're living in the dark times. Congress is not helping us. Trying to roll back. Bring up voter suppression, trying now to pass another crazy, wild, outlandish law that can allow somebody to drive in the midst with a car of a protest and say, accidentally I killed or wounded somebody, and be forgiven because we're the ones protesting. But if God be for us, who can be against us? If ever we needed the Lord before, we sure do need him now. If ever we need a sister right now, that would be now. If ever we need to see servants, if ever there's a need for succor from the church, collectively and individually, that time would be now. We are in the midst of some trying situations, but we as a people have been here before. Come on, help me, songwriter. Stone of the road we tried, bitter the chasing rod. We know how to get through hard times. When we fall on hard times, we don't just give up and die. When we fall on hard times, we do not give up and die. We fall on our knees and cry out to God. Oh, God, it's not my mother. It's not my father. Oh, but it's me, oh, Lord. I'm standing in the need of prayer. God will show up. He may not come when I want him. Oh, but he's always on time. He gives me power for my weakness. He gives me strength for my strain. He bears a heavy burden. Dries up all of our tears. Dries away our fears. Takes me through the valleys. Come out on the other side with victory. Talking about up above my head, I hear music in the air. Oh, there must be a God somewhere. His name is Jesus. Beautiful portrait of a servant. Phoebe was all that. We applaud you. We encourage you. Stay the course. Don't think about leaving your ministry. Stop. That's not of God. I know sometimes ministry gets hard by the yard. It's not a cinch by the inch. We can't do this on our own. You may get tired. Tell God, God, I can't do this on my own. God said, that's the first great recognition I need you to have, to realize that you cannot serve as a servant of God on your own. He gives me power for my weakness. He gives me strength for my stress. He gives me joy for hard places. He makes me walk on through the night, knowing that daybreak is nearby. Paul goes on to pour out more love. Not only Phoebe, he said, greet Priscilla and Aquila, my helpers in Christ. If there's anything ought to be emphatically clear, is that we are all in this ministry together. Everybody's help is needed. You don't need a title to carry out a task. You don't need to be elevated. You don't need to be publicly recognized. God needs all of us to be his helpers. Paul talks about this dynamic couple, Priscilla and Aquila. What I found out by research was this. In biblical times, men and women sat in different sections of the church. Sometimes they would sit according to trade. Tent makers sat with tent makers. Men sat with men and women with women. Paul realizes that he was helped by this dynamic couple, Priscilla and Aquila, in verse 3. The fourth point, and I'm almost home. She was a sister, a servant, and a succorer. Now look at what verse 4 says for the fourth S. Who have for my life laid down their own necks. And to whom not only I give thanks, but also the churches of the Gentiles. Romans, as I said, was primarily written to the Gentiles, who had a little more faith than the Jews did at this time. Paul said, not only must we be sisters and brothers in the Lord, not only is God calling us to be servants and to give succor, he's calling us to be sacrificial. I've said 100 times before, now let me make it 101. Not much valuable ministry occurs on Comfort Boulevard. It's on Sacrificial Drive. A ministry that does not cost much is probably not worth much. It's going to cost you and me to be servants, but what a precious privilege to pay the cost, for our cost doesn't even pale in comparison to the cost that Jesus, our Lord and Savior, made. They laid down their nets for Paul. When God leads you and me, we will live sacrificially that others may come out of darkness and walk in the marvelous light today. Can I get a witness up in here this morning? What is God calling you and me to lay down for him? One disciple said, God, we've given up everything for you. What do we get? When you serve the Lord, when you offer succor and you become sacrificial, I declare we cannot ever even begin to approach all that God's going to do for us. They were sacrificial. It's not about convenience. It's about commitment. It's not always about delight. It's about desire and dedication. It's not always about being popular, but it's about being prayerful. How do we serve? One challenge and fault of us leaders, we spend far too much time on our feet and not enough time on our knees. Let me repeat in case you missed it. As leaders, one of our challenges is, and one of our faults is in the midst of our strength is that we spend way and far too much time on our feet and not enough time on our knees calling on God. We got to pray your way through this situation. Pray for insight. Pray for wisdom. Pray for how to approach. Pray that we should minister properly to those that are in need. Pray like somebody's life depends on it, because it does. Pray in the morning, pray in the noonday, pray in the evening, or pray in the midnight hour. Pray like never before. Pray without ceasing. In everything, pray. Make our request known to God, and He will give the peace of God that passes all understanding. A beautiful portrait of a servant. When the doors of the church are open in the very near future, stay tuned for coming announcements. You'll be given sufficient notice to prepare yourself to begin the transition. When you come back, be ready to serve, not just show up, serve up. Be ready to make a few sacrifices for somebody. Matter of fact, if you're living so good, you still have blessings pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Can you share some of your love? Can you share some of God's blessing with somebody? I was in McDonald's yesterday morning getting me some oatmeal, trying to stay healthy. Brother on the side looked a little distressed. I said, let me give you a little piece of change. He said, man, you must have known that I needed it. God just put on my spirit that somebody else should be blessed by the blessings that we receive. Priscilla and Aquila were a sacrificing couple. And verse 5 said, likewise, I greet the church that is in their house. Biblical times were known for small church houses. This mega church syndrome is a new age phenomenon. And everybody is not happy at a mega church, but we do serve a mega God. See, here's the crux of it. God is not so concerned about a large seating capacity, but He is concerned about your large succoring capacity and your large serving capacity. He greeted those at the church house, Priscilla and Aquila. Salute my well-beloved Epaphras, who is the first fruits of Acacia and unto Christ. Paul loved the Lord, but he also loved people. You and I can't really be effective, powerful, anointed servants unless we really love God, and we must love God's people. Even in the midst of challenging time, you got to walk in love. You got to take stuff that gets up on your skin, make the hair on the back of your neck raise up. You got to be able to take that and keep on trekking, keep on serving. Don't take your spiritual gifts and go home. No, don't do that. Serve in love like Paul did. Lastly, then I'm done. Greet Mary, who bestowed much labor on us. It's good to bestow much labor, but that labor must be love-driven. If you're just working to be seen, working out of dull duty, that thing will destroy you. It'll wear you down. But if you are laboring because you love, God will fill you and spill you. You hear the old deaconess pray, Lord, I come before you this Sunday morning as an empty pitcher before a full fountain. Fill me. Spill me in your service. And when you fill me and spill me in your service, then come back again. Fill me and spill me in your service. I'm love driven. That's what keeps me going. That's what keeps me moving. That's what makes me go when I'm tired. That's what leaves me when I feel like watching television. Love lifting me. See, there was a time I was sinking deep in my sin. You know, I was far from the peace of shore. Battle stained and bruised within. Didn't think I'd rise no more. Oh, but the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From the waters lifted me, now safe am I. It was love. But God, commending His love, rolled over His love on you and me there. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. That's our message. That's our story, and I'm staying with it. I'm about to close. I thank you for your prayers and your patience. But the Lord been just real good. Serve for the glory of God. Let nobody and no one stand in your way. Be a sister. And by the way, be a brother. Sister and a brother loveth at all time. A sister and a brother are born for adversity. Serve as God leads you with joy and delight. What a privilege, what a blessing. Give succor. Ask God to tune your spiritual radar so that you can detect hurt behind the smile. Harm behind the position. You have the spirit and gift of discernment so you can share some succor. Sometimes it's just as simple and profound as listening to somebody that's going through, giving your undivided attention. When we can visit the restaurants and share a lunch and a brunch and a breakfast and a dinner, just be there to give succor in a time of need, in a time of distress, in a time of trouble. Ask God to humble you and me so we can stretch out, become sacrificial. That we would work while it's day. Nights coming when no man can work. Nights coming when no deaconess of woman can work. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. May this be your day of spiritual breakthrough. And if you don't know this great God that we serve, oh, I would plead with you, urge you, encourage you, walk with you, so that you can come out of darkness and begin to walk in the marvelous light. We have loving, caring, devoted counselors who are waiting to receive your call today. Don't delay, call today. It is urgent. It is of utmost importance. It is primary. It is 911 time to get to know Jesus Christ in the midst of this world in which we live. Pray that Jesus will come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior today. For today is a day of salvation, and the day you hear God's voice, don't harden your heart in the midst of all of life's uncertainties. You don't want to let another day go by that you're not walking with the Lord, King of kings and Lord of lords. May God bless you as you become a servant of God. Revelation 14:13 says, blessed are they that die in the Lord, and their rest from their labors and their works do follow them. May that be your story. May that be your song of praise. We pray for all those families today that are experiencing mourning and bereavement all over the country. We pray that this would be a death-free week for us. Know that God is working for us, even when it seems and appears that others are working against us. Yes, I'm aware of all the trauma, but I tend to be inclined. I've had some emotional roller coaster experiences this week. Justice rolled down on Tuesday like a mighty stream, and then tears flowed down like a mighty stream on Wednesday. Up, I said, I got to look to the hills when cometh my help, because all of my help coming from the Lord. Look to Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross and despised the shame, and is now seated at the right hand of God, where he ever liveth to make intercession for you and for me. Eternal God, our Father, we come on behalf of every family that's suffering loss of child, loved one, job, business, hope, that you would pour out your blessings like never before. You would open up the windows of heaven. You would send rapid cures for this COVID-19 pandemic, that the vaccine would do all that it's supposed to do, and that those who are reluctant would receive, that healing may begin. You would touch every lawmaker and realize that they are under your authority. One glad morning, one glad noon, that the government shall be upon your shoulders. You will rule this whole world. But in the meantime, God, give us strength. Help us to be your servants that bring honor and glory to your name. Bind up every broken heart. Set the captives free. Give the oil of gladness for mourning, and they can take off their garments of mourning and bereavement and put on the garments of praise, become as a tree of righteousness. Now may the amazing grace of God, the agape love of God, the infinite mercy of God rest rule and abide with you and us all, both now, henceforth, and forevermore. Until then, let's walk with the King and be a blessing. Have a great day and a great week. We'll see you soon.
Thank you, Pastor Lyles, for that wonderful word from the Lord. We pray that today's message touched your heart.
If you would like to give your heart to Jesus by receiving him as your Lord and Savior, or would simply like for someone to pray with you, we have altar counselors waiting to take your call. The telephone numbers will be listed on the screen, and the lines will remain open for 2 hours after the service. Please don't hesitate to call.
We hope you will join us again next week for our online services. But until then, have a blessed week and continue to stay safe and healthy.
Show me your face. Fill up the space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right now. I can't escape being afraid. Substitutes right now. Fix what I see, and God, please fix me. My world needs you right now. Let us see you right now.
Show me your face. Fill up this space.
The world needs
you. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right now.
That's why I'm not ashamed to say.
back here after the service.
Good morning, Fort Foote Baptist Church congregation. I want to say thank you for tuning in today. We have a good services planned for you today because God is in charge and he's going to make sure it happens. So now let's go to the Lord in prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father God, we first want to say thank you for this day, Father God. Here's a day that we've never seen before, but with your blessings, here we are living within today. Lord, we ask that you bless this church, Father God, this whole entire congregation. Lord, we ask blessings over the pastor, Father God. Use him in a mighty way. Give him the word for your congregation, something that we need to hear today, Father God, that will touch in each and every one of our hearts. Lord, we ask blessings over this whole world, Father God, as we go through this pandemic that we are currently in. Lord, we know you are in charge, and despite the fact that we're going through a valley now, tomorrow is a brighter day. So, Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we ask forgiveness for all of our sins that we have committed. We lift you up and we praise you, Father God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Amen.
Sing, Lord, you're mighty. 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 Lord, you're mighty. Sing, Lord, you're mighty. I want to hear you sing, Lord, you're mighty. Sing, Lord, you're mighty. Sing, Lord, you're mighty. That's it. Sing, Lord, you're mighty. Sing, Lord, you're mighty. Sing, Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Oh, Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. You said your glory above the heavens and the earth. When I think of all you made, the sun, the moon, and the stars, no praise is high enough to express how great you are.
What a mighty God we serve.
Let the angels bow before the mighty.